For over 25 years, students from across the Granite State have come together to match wits with their peers. The competition can be fierce, but so can the fun. Even so, the stakes are high because only one team can win. The Granite State Challenge! Now, here's your host, Jim Janot.
All right, thank you very much, and hi everybody. Welcome to another game of Granite State Challenge. Well, we are at the end of our first round of competition. This is week number 16. 15 teams from high schools around the state have won games to move on into our second round. Two other schools ready to compete tonight. The winner also to advance into our second round of competition, which begins next week. Let's show you where the teams are from playing in tonight's game. First of all, we have the team from Bishop Brady High School. It has an enrollment of approximately 400 students. Bishop Brady is located in New Hampshire's Merrimack County.
Hi, I'm Nick, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm James, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Zach, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Anupa, and I'm a junior.
With us for the program, the coach for the team, he is Eric Diamond. The alternates are Connor Houghton and Tom Arena. They are the Green Giants from Bishop Brady High School. All right, you've met the team from Bishop Brady. Now let's meet the team that they'll be competing against. That is the team from Mascenic Regional High School. It has an enrollment of about 420 students. Mascenic Regional is located in New Hampshire's Hillsborough County.
Hi, I'm Tim and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Zave and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Stephanie and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Robert and I'm a senior.
The team is coached by Karen McDonough and Deborah Gerald. The alternates are Josh McLeod and Stephanie Worrabee, and they are the Vikings from Mascenic Regional High School. Our last introduction is what we do each and every week at this time, let you know who our judges are. Once again tonight, we welcome back Ann Belanger and Mary Riley Potter. All right, we're ready to go into round number one. We play in four rounds. Round one is our toss-up round, then the bonus in 60 seconds. We tell you all about that as we get to those. But right now, Bishop Brady and Mascenic, these are 10-point toss-ups. Here we go. Which musical instrument consists of two cup-shaped wooden clappers clicked together rhythmically by Spanish dancers? They are castanets. Name the two U.S. states with smaller areas than Puerto Rico. Tim of Mascenic.
Rhode Island and Connecticut.
Bishop Brady. James.
Rhode Island and Delaware.
That's correct. Rhode Island and Delaware. For 10 points, who drafted the original Massachusetts Constitution, the world's oldest functioning written constitution that served as a model for the U.S. Constitution? Drafted by John Adams. Give the Spanish word for town or village that is used to name Nick of Bishop Brady.
Pueblo.
Pueblo is correct. Which war is the setting for Stephen Crane's The Red Badge of Courage, Nick of Bishop Brady?
The U.S. Civil War.
The Civil War is right. For your next 10-pointer, this actor and comedian attended Manchester Central High School. Nick of Bishop Brady.
Adam Sandler.
Got his start on The Cosby Show, where he played Theo's friend Smitty in four episodes. Indeed, it was Adam Sandler. Which Austrian musician, nicknamed the Waltz King, wrote the popular waltz on the beautiful Blue Danube? James of Brady.
Schubert.
Mascenic. Stephanie.
Bach.
It was Johann Strauss, Jr. What term associated with periodic functions is described by the following? One half the difference of the maximum and minimum values of the function. James of Bishop Brady.
Amplitude.
Amplitude is correct. Now for 10 points, in which city, which is surrounded by another city, is St. Peter's Square located? Nick of Bishop Brady.
Vatican City.
Vatican City is right. This Charlestown, Massachusetts native invented the telegraph. James of Bishop Brady.
Samuel Morse.
Samuel Morse is also correct. Which literary work by E.B. White includes the lines, Wilbur admired the way she managed? James of Brady.
Charlotte's Web.
Charlotte's Web, another 10 points, correct. Now tell me, what is the name of the lake that the old man of the mountain used to look over? Nick of Brady.
Lake Winnipesaukee.
Mascenic. Tim.
Franconia Lake.
It is Profile Lake. American comic strip artist Bob Montana, who summered in Meredith, New Hampshire with his family and attended Manchester Central High School in his senior year, is the creator of this comic series featuring Betty, Veronica, and Jughead. James of Brady.
Archie
Comics is correct. Which presidential candidate made the Cross of Gold speech? Nick of Brady.
William Jennings Bryan.
William Jennings Bryan is also right. When Lady Astor said to him, "If I were married to you, I'd put poison in your coffee," which British politician, James of Brady? I can repeat it for Mascenic. When Lady Astor said to him, "If I were married to you, I'd put poison in your coffee," which British politician allegedly responded, "And if you were my wife, I'd drink it"? Xavier of Mascenic.
Winston Churchill.
Winston Churchill is right for your 10 points. This Cornish, New Hampshire native served as a U.S. Treasury Secretary under Abraham Lincoln. He was also governor of Ohio and Chief Justice, Nick of Brady.
Salmon Chase.
Salmon Chase is absolutely right. Who was elected President of the United States by the House of Representatives on February 9, 1825, after no candidate received a majority during the Electoral College voting? Nick of Brady?
John Quincy Adams.
John Quincy Adams is right. This New Hampshire mountain was known as Mount Pleasant until 1972, when its name was changed to honor this 20th century American president. Robert of Mascenic.
Mount Washington.
Good try. Bishop Brady, James.
Mount Pierce.
Actually, the 20th U.S. president was Eisenhower. The mountain is now known as Mount Eisenhower. What river separates southern Maine and New Hampshire? Tim of Mascenic.
The Androscoggin River.
Good try, Brady. Nick.
The Piscataqua.
Piscataqua River is correct. Identify the small discs floating in the blood plasma that are involved in the process of blood clotting. Stephanie of Mascenic?
Platelets.
Platelets is right. Tell me now, what is the sum of the prime factors of 21? We want the sum of the prime factors of 21, Tim of Mascenic?
10.
10 is correct. Which American author wrote, "But in this world nothing is certain but death and taxes"? Nick of Brady.
Benjamin Franklin.
Benjamin Franklin wrote that. That's correct. In which year did the United States celebrate the 200th anniversary of its Constitution? Nick of Brady.
1981.
Mascenic? Stephanie?
1976.
The Constitution was 1987. And there's the sound ending our round. Well, it's Bishop Brady getting the lead after round number one, but we'll be heading into a very big bonus round in just a moment. Before we get there, though, as you know, throughout the season, Lori Warner joins us at this time. As you also know, that prior to each program, she meets up with the team members that are participating that evening. Right now, she's talking with the team members from Bishop Brady High School.
Thanks, Jim. We have the students from Bishop Brady here, and this is the part that all of the students look forward to, is when they get to talk into the microphone. So we have our first, our captain, Nick Amadeo, and your great-great-great-grandfather is a legend in Chile.
Yes, he's a Chilean Revolutionary War hero. He was a dashing cavalry officer who died a hero at the Battle of Maipú, and I believe his last words were, "I wish for my great-great-great-great-grandson to compete in the Quiz Bowl in New Hampshire."
And so it's a win Granite State challenge.
I'm living out his dream.
That's wonderful. I think that these guys might be kind of funny. Next we have James Kiefner. Now you, when you're done with school, maybe before college, maybe after, you want to go to China and study martial arts.
I do. I've been studying Chinese Kung Fu for 4 or 5 years now. Mm-hmm. And last summer I went to a study program to study Chinese language and culture.
Oh, wow.
And I thought it was really, really interesting. Mm-hmm. So I'd really like to travel to either the Shaolin Temple or the Wudong Temple, mm-hmm. which are in northern and southern China, respectively, and study martial arts for
Go
a few
both.
Months.
Go
yeah, of course.
And you know grasshopper, right?
Oh, naturally.
Kung Fu, all right. Grasshopper. Good luck with that. Anupa Murali, you're a junior. Now, you do a lot of the math competitions.
Yes, I do.
And they look to you for all the answers on this team, don't they?
On the math questions, yes.
Okay.
Yep.
Pretty much.
How have you done in the math contests?
Well, I've done quite a few, and so far it's going very well. This year I'm going to be competing in Canadian math competitions as well, because I'm a Canadian citizen.
Oh, cool.
Last year I did them, and I made it to the Canadian Math Olympiad.
Excellent.
And in eighth grade I made it to the USA Math Olympiad.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Wow. So you've done very, very well. Unlike Zach, who's made it to the theater and the drama.
Yes.
What shows have you been in, Zach?
While in high school, I've been in six shows, mm-hmm. And then I stage managed for one.
Oh, excellent.
And
are these all school productions?
Yeah, and one of them was a student production, mm-hmm. So we had a student director.
Mm-hmm. I can see where you'd be excellent at them. We have to get back to the game, though, because you have to win now.
I do.
Okay, so that's their big thing, is they're here to win for great, great, great grandfather in Chile. Back to you, Jim.
All right, thank you very much, Lori, and we welcome the team from Bishop Brady High School. Right now, after round one, they have a lead, but we come to a very big bonus round with a lot of extra points up for grabs. 10-point toss-ups remain the same. If you get the toss-up correctly, your team has a chance at additional bonus points. So Brady and Mascenic, good luck. Here we go for 10 points. We want you to name the mass of specialized protoplasm found in the cells of most organisms, without which the cell cannot divide. For nucleus. What word designates a surgeon who specializes in surgery involving the brain or any area of the nervous system? Stephanie of Mascenic?
A neurosurgeon.
Neurosurgeon is correct for the 10 points. So over to Mascenic we go. Tim, you're the team captain. You'll be giving the answer for the team. But right now, let's choose a category from That Rings a Bell, Full Steam Ahead, or The Midas Touch. You can talk it over. That Rings a Bell, Full Steam Ahead, or The Midas Touch.
Midas Touch.
Let's go with The Midas Touch. And again, Tim, you can talk to everybody, but I take your answer for the team. 5 points apiece. Identify these millionaires. He was the co-founder of Microsoft and now runs a foundation with his wife, Melinda.
Bill Gates.
Correct. He is a real estate developer in New York who seems to enjoy firing people on TV.
Donald Trump.
Correct. She is the host of her own TV show and played a huge role in getting books on the bestseller list.
Oprah Winfrey.
15 out of 15, like that, on the bonus. Let's go with another 10-point toss-up. Which United States president was in office when the Iran-Contra affair occurred in the 1980s? Nick or Brady?
Ronald Reagan.
Ronald Reagan is correct. So over to Brady we go with a chance at some bonus points. Nick, you speak for the team. Choose from these categories. That Rings a Bell, Full Steam Ahead, or Cream of the Crop? That Rings a Bell, Full Steam Ahead, or Cream of the Crop?
That Rings a Bell.
Let's go with That Rings a Bell. And again, Nick, talk to everybody. I take your answer for the team. Identify the following related to bells. Novel by Ernest Hemingway set during the Spanish Civil War.
For Whom the Bell Tolls.
Correct. She was a fairy in Peter Pan.
Tinkerbell.
Tinkerbell.
Correct. The type of bells you might have in a one-horse open sleigh.
Sleigh bells.
Judges, will you take that? No, actually we gave the word sleigh. We're not going to take it. It's going to be jingle bells is what we were looking for. All right, here we go. 10 out of 15 there. Let's go with a 10-point toss-up. Name the American playwright who wrote A Delicate Balance. Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf and The Zoo Story? His name was Edward Albee. Let's try a math question. There's paper and pencil in front of you, teams, if you want to use it. If Japan's new faster bullet train makes the 320-mile trip between Tokyo and Osaka in 2.5 hours, how many miles per hour does the train average? And we'll give you a little time there. If Japan's new faster bullet train makes the 320-mile trip between Tokyo and Osaka in 2.5 hours, Anupa of Bishop Brady.
128 miles per hour
is correct. Okay, back over to Brady we go for Full Steam Ahead. Cream of the Crop or You Can't Get There From Here. Full Steam Ahead, Cream of the Crop, You Can't Get There From Here.
You Can't Get There From Here.
All right, 5 points apiece. Identify these places that are hidden from most people. Dorothy and her sidekicks went here to consult with the wizard.
The Emerald City.
Judges? We're looking for Oz. You'll find no muggles in this boarding school.
Hogwarts.
Correct. This mysterious Scottish village appears for only one day every 100 years.
Pass.
That is Brigadoon. 5 out of the 15 on the bonus. Let's go with a toss-up. At one time, this New Hampshire city in the Monadnock region claimed to have the widest paved main street in the world. Xavier of Mascenic.
Concord.
Mr. Brady. Nick?
Keene.
Keene is right for the 10 points. Let's go back to Brady for full steam ahead. Cream of the crop or throws like a girl? Full steam ahead, cream of the crop.
Full steam ahead.
Let's go with full steam ahead. Identify these famous trains. This train began service from Paris to Istanbul in 1883 and was the setting for murder in an Agatha Christie novel.
The Orient Express.
Orient Express is right. This train in Japan can reach speeds of up to 186 miles per hour.
The bullet train?
Correct. This train climbs to the top of Mount Washington.
The cog railway.
15 out of 15 on the bonus. And there's the sound ending our round. And right now, Bishop Brady maintains the lead halfway through the game with our 60-second round coming right up. Before we get there, though, we're going to ask Lori to rejoin us. This time she's talking with the team members from Mascenic Regional High School.
Thanks, Jim. We've got the students from Mascenic High School with us right now. And first we'll talk to Captain Tim Allen. Now, you went to St. Paul's School last summer.
Yes, I did. I went to their advanced studies program. I studied ancient Greece there, so made many friends. It's great all over the state of New Hampshire.
Now we know that. And you also did some volunteer work last summer.
Yeah, I volunteered. Since I've been in high school, I've been volunteering at the local Boys and Girls Club over the summer. So,
what town is that in?
Milford, New Hampshire.
In Milford, right. Okay.
And I do about 300 hours a summer, so.
Wow, that's like a full-time job.
Yeah.
Oh, that's terrific. All right, well, our next student is Stephanie Brundage. You are a senior also.
Yeah.
You were vice president last year, and you volunteer over at the Bedford Humane Society.
Yeah, I clean cat cages there. There's a lot of animals to adopt, so go visit.
And whenever you're thinking about bringing one into your family, visit the Humane Society first. You sound like a good commercial for them. So what is it that brought you to volunteer over there?
Our school started a new diploma program. Mm-hmm. It's called the Superintendent's Diploma. And so I now need 24 hours of community service logged. And I haven't logged any over the past year. So I'm like, oh, I guess I got to start over.
Okay.
So I like animals, and I decided to go there.
That's a great thing to do. It is. And Xavier, you are a Boy Scout. You are the president of the drama club.
I am indeed.
And how did you manage that?
I asked for it, actually. They're like, oh, you've done so much. You can just take the part. They didn't even do much for it. For the elections. They're like, yeah, you've done so much. You just... We'd like you to do this for us.
Oh, that's terrific. Well, that's an easy way to do it. Now, and what productions are on tap for this year?
This year, we're planning on doing But Why Bump Off Barnaby, which I think we're trying to put on in December. Mm-hmm. And it's a really funny murder mystery, actually.
No, that sounds good.
Yeah.
That sounds good. Well, good luck
that's
with
hilarious.
That. And Robert Tatro, who said I could call him Mr. So, Mr. Tatro, after school, what do you want to do? You had some really interesting things to say.
Well, I feel like I want to go to Keene State College because they have pretty much the best Holocaust and genocidal studies there, and I found that to be where my passion is going towards after I've seen things from historical documents and all that stuff after I took my Holocaust class, and I felt that's where I needed to go.
It's a good thing to prevent ever happening again. Mm-hmm. All right, well, so hats off to you, and we'll get back to the game now and see what happens. It's over to you, Jim.
Very well done, Lori. Thank you. And to the team members from Mascenic Regional High School, we welcome you. And right now we head into our third round, as we'll be asking each team 10 questions in 1 minute in this, our 60-second round. We give them 10 points for every right answer. We'll bonus them 10 if they get them all right in under a minute. So, Mascenic, you do trail, so you get to choose the categories first. Choose from Johnny Come Lately, Dynamic Duos, or It's a Small World.
Johnny, it's a small world.
Let's go with It's a Small World. And again, Tim, you talk to everybody, but I do take your answer for the team. We want you to identify these small things. Start the clock. Smallest U.S. state?
Rhode Island.
Correct. Basic unit of matter that consists of a nucleus surrounded by electrons.
Cell.
It is an atom. Corsican, who crowned himself Emperor of France?
Napoleon.
Correct. These birds can flap their wings around 80 times per second.
Hummingbird.
Correct. Where the stirrup bone is found in the body.
Pass.
1/1,000,000,000th of a second.
Jiffy?
It is a nanosecond. The smallest planet in our solar system, and it's not Pluto.
Mercury?
Correct. Smallest ocean in the world.
Indian Ocean?
It is the Arctic. Microorganism smaller than a bacteria which cannot grow or reproduce apart from a living cell.
Pass.
And small inhabitants of Oz.
Munchkins.
Is correct, judges. Five out of 10. Well done on their 60-second round. So 50 points onto the scoreboard for Mascenic Regional. We'll go on over to Bishop Brady and offer them Johnny Come Lately or Dynamic Duos.
Dynamic Duos.
Let's go with the Dynamic Duos. And again, Nick, I take your answer for the team. Identify the following pairs. Start the clock. They had an excellent time traveling adventure.
Pat.
These two Muppets share a home. One likes pigeons, the other rubber duckies.
Bert and Ernie.
Correct. This brother and sister pair discover a candy and cake house in the woods.
Hansel and Gretel.
Correct. They led an overland expedition to the Pacific coast.
Lewis and Clark.
Correct. Star-crossed teen lovers in a Shakespearean
Romeo
play.
Romeo and Juliet.
Correct. Songwriting duo who wrote the music for Oklahoma, Carousel, and The Sound of Music.
Pass.
Famous feuding families from the backwoods of West Virginia and Kentucky.
Hatfields McCoys.
Correct. Male and female outlaws who robbed banks during
Bunny
the...
Bunny Clyde.
Correct. Sons of Adam and Eve.
Cain and Abel.
Correct. Moose and Flying Squirrel from the 1960s cartoon series. Say again.
Rocky and Bullwinkle.
You got them. Judges? 8 out of 10 on their 60-second round on Dynamic Duo. So a dynamic 80 points onto the scoreboard for Bishop Brady. And we head into the fourth and final round with Brady holding on to that lead that they got back in round number one. 10-point toss-ups the rest of the way, teams. No more talking. Good luck, and here we go. In which George Orwell novel does Winston Smith begin his Nick of Bishop
1984.
Brady? 1984 is correct. What we'd like you to do is name the process in which a gas cools to become a liquid as when, James of Bishop Brady?
Condensation.
Condensation is when air cools, releasing tiny drops of liquid. In which Shakespearean play does Mercutio provide... Nick of Bishop Brady.
Romeo and Juliet.
Yeah, we got another one of those questions for you. Let's go with another 10-point toss-up. Give the term for a metal having a specific gravity of 5.0 or higher, especially one that is toxic to organisms. James of Brady.
A heavy metal?
Heavy metal is exactly what we were looking for. On March 26, 1953, which scientist announced a new vaccine against polio? Zach of Brady.
Jonas Salk.
Jonas Salk is correct for your 10 points. Now for another 10-point toss-up, we want you to name the battle in which Marcus Brutus and Cassius were defeated by the combined armies of Antony and Octavian in 42 B.C. Zach of Bishop Brady.
Philippi.
Battle of Philippi is well done. What term beginning with B names the style of music for which Johann Sebastian Bach is noted, Nick of Bishop Brady?
Baroque.
Baroque is absolutely right. All right, we have just about 2 minutes to play in our game. Among the wildlife in the Arctic National Wildlife Refuge is the world's largest terrestrial carnivore, namely which animal that feeds, Zach of Bishop Brady?
The polar bear.
I can repeat it for Mascenic, but I won't, Stephanie.
Walrus.
We're looking for the grizzly bear, the world's largest terrestrial carnivore, namely which animal that feeds on roots, berries, and a caribou. About a minute and a half to go. Identify the punctuation marks used to enclose dialogue. Anupa, Bishop Brady.
Quotation marks.
Quotation marks is correct. What are the beginning and ending months of the hurricane season in the United States? James of Bishop Brady.
August and November.
Mascenic, Tim?
April and October.
Actually, it's June and November. Identify the soil in Ireland called Irish gold because of its use as an environmentally friendly fuel in a country with little coal or oil, Nick of Brady?
Peat.
Peat is correct, under a minute to play. Which long fracture in the Earth's crust is marked by a zone of disrupted land in California? Nick of Brady.
San Andreas Fault.
San Andreas Fault is correct. Which poet, known for his collection Tamerlane, wrote the lines, Helen, thy beauty is to me like the grandeur that was Rome. Nick of Brady.
Edgar Allan Poe.
Edgar Allan Poe is right on the money. Identify the art term for a drawing that distorts a subject's distinctive features for a grotesque or humorous effect. James of Bishop
Caricature.
Brady. Caricature is right. Name the insect known for its bioluminescence whose young hatch from larvae known as glowworms. Nick of Brady.
Firefly.
The firefly is also correct. Now for 10 points. Nope, no more 10-pointers. That's it. Our game is over. Bishop Brady, a nice win here tonight with a victory over Mascenic Regional High School, becoming our 16th and a final winner of round one competitions and becoming the 16th team to move on into the second round of play. So congratulations to Bishop Brady. And for you folks at home, we want you to get ready now because second round play begins next week. Our first second round game will pit the teams from Merrimack Valley High School against Belmont High School. That's our game next week. Thanks for watching tonight. Good night, everybody.